Hello everyone, this is Professor M.S. Koite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, Kekiwa College of Agriculture, Nasik. So, welcome back in today's session. So, in today's session, we are going to learn about the classification of insect. Firstly, the definition of entomology. So, the entomology, it is a Greek word. Means the entomon means the insect and logos means the study. And the definition of entomology is, it is a branch of zoology or biological science that deals with the study of insects. Then next definition is the insect. So the definition of insect is, the insects are the tracheate arthropods in which the body is divided into the head, thorax and the abdomen, possessing the two pairs of the wings and the three pairs of the legs and single pair of antennas. So this is the definition of insect, and insects are the tracheate arthropods in which the body is divided into the mainly three regions. So first one is the head, then second one is the thorax, and third one is the abdomen. So on the thorax, there are two pairs of the wings respectively on a mesothorax and the metathorax, and the three pairs of the legs on the prothorax, mesothorax and the metathorax, and a single pair of antennae on the head of an insect. So this is the definition of an insect. Then next is the branches of entomology. So first one is the forensic entomology, means the study and use of the insect in crime investigation is known as a forensic entomology. Then second is the veterinary entomology, the study of insects related to the livestock and veterinary animals is known as the veterinary entomology. And third branch of the entomology is medical entomology. So study of insect in relation to human beings is known as the medical entomology. So these are the branches of entomology. So let us start our today's topic, that is classification of insect. So insects are the invertebrates grouped in the phylum Arthropoda. So meaning of Arthropoda is, arthros means the joint and poda means the foot or a leg, and this belongs to subphylum Uniramia. The next point is the characters of the phylum Arthropoda. So first one is they having the segmented body. Then segments group into the two or three regions are also called as the tagma. This process known as a tagmosis. Then renewable chitinous exoskeleton. Then the insects or the arthropods grow by the molting. Then they having the bilateral symmetry of a body. Then body cavity filled with the blood and called as a hemocoel. Then tubular elementary canal with the mouth and anus at the anterior and posterior ends. The next characteristics of arthropod is the dorsal hurt with the wall like ostia. Then dorsal brain with the ventral nerve cord. Then striated muscles with the dark and light bands. Then no cilia, means the hair like vibratile structure on the surface of the cell. Then last one is the paired and segmented appendages. So these are the different characters or characteristics of the phylum Arthropoda. Then phylum Arthropoda is classified into the mainly seven classes. So first class is Onychophora, means the claw bearing. Example is Peripatus. Second class of a phylum Arthropoda is Crustacea. Crusta means the shell. So example are prawn, crab and woodlouse. Then third class is the Arachnida. So Arachnids means spider, and the example of the Arachnida classes are the scorpion, spider, ticks and mite. Fourth class of the phylum Arthropoda is Chilopoda. So chilo means the leaf and poda means the appendages. So example is centipedes. Then fifth one is a Diplopoda. So diplo means two and poda means the appendages. So example of Diplopoda is millipedes. Then sixth class is Trilobita. It is an extinct group. Example is Trilobite. Then seventh class of the phylum Arthropoda is Hexapoda. So hexa means the six and poda means the legs. Or Hexapoda are also called as the insecta. So in means the internal and sect means the cut. So example of Hexapoda is insect. So these are the different seven classes of the phylum Arthropoda. So let us see one by one. First class of the phylum Arthropoda is Onychophora. So animals forms the connecting link between the phylum Annelida and Arthropoda. So the Onychophoran or the peripatus forms the connecting link between the phylum Annelida and Arthropoda. Then second characteristics, animals are terrestrial and worm-like. Then third one is the body is unsegmented externally with numerous pairs of the unjointed legs, and this is the peripatus. Then second class of the phylum Arthropoda is Trilobita. So animals are marine forms with a three lobe molded body. First one is the unsegmented head called the cephalon. Then second one is the flexible trunk means the thorax, and third one is the pygidium means unsegmented tail. So these are the three different three lobed molded body regions. And the second characteristic is head possesses single pair of antennae, and body is unsegmented externally with the numerous pairs of unjointed limbs. So this is the example of Trilobita class, Trilobite. Then third class of phylum Arthropoda is Crustacea. So animals are predominantly marine, and body is divided into the cephalothorax and the abdomen. And animal possesses five pair of legs and two pairs of the antennae. Then respiration in Crustacea takes place by means of the gills. So these are the different examples like the crab, prawn and oodlers. It belongs to class Crustacea. Then next class of the phylum Arthropoda is Arachnida, in which the body is divided into the two parts, that is cephalothorax and abdomen. So cephalothorax means it is the fusion of head and the thorax, called as the cephalothorax, and second one is the abdomen. They bear four pair of legs, and antennae are absent in arachnids. Instead of antennae, chelicerae and pedipalpi present. And the respiration takes place by the using lung books and the trachea. So these are the examples of arachnids: scorpion, spider, ticks and mites. Then next class of phylum Arthropoda is Myriapoda, in which the body is divided into two parts, head and trunk, and it bears a single pair of antennae. Each body segment bears appendages, respiration by the lung books and the trachea. And the Myriapoda is divided into the two subclasses. First one is the Diplopoda, and second one is the, or the second subclasses is the class is the Chilopoda. So the example of Diplopoda is millipedes, and example of Chilopoda is the centipedes. Then last class of the phylum Arthropoda is Insecta, or also called as the Hexapoda, in which the body is divided into the distinct regions, head, thorax and abdomen. So single pair of antennae present on a head, and three pairs of legs present on the thorax, particularly on a prothorax, mesothorax and the metathorax, and the two pairs of the wings on the thorax, on the mesothorax and the metathorax. Then the genital openings are situated on the 8th and 9th abdominal segment, and respiration by means of the trachea. And insect undergoes the metamorphosis. The metamorphosis means the change in the form of insect. Then process exoskeleton made up of hard cuticle, which plays important role for survival, and excretion is mainly by the Malpighian tubules, which helps in the maintaining ionic balance. So Malpighian tubules is the main excretory organs of excretory system in an insect. So these are the different characteristics of class Insecta, or also called as the Hexapoda. Then next one is the class Insecta or Hexapoda is divided into the two subclasses, that is Apterygota and Pterygota. So this is the difference between Apterygota and Pterygota. First one is the Apterygota are the primarily wingless insect, and the Pterygota they are the wing or secondarily wingless insect. Then metamorphosis is totally absent or slightly present in Apterygota, and the metamorphosis is present in the Pterygota insect. Then mandibles articulated with the head capsule at a single point in Apterygota, and in Pterygota the mandibles are double or two in number, and the pleural sulcus is in thorax is absent in Apterygota and which is present in the Pterygota. So this is the difference between Apterygota and Pterygota. So let us see one by one. So first is Apterygota. So in Apterygota there are different four orders. So first order is Thysanura, means or the example is bristle tails, silverfish, fire brats. And the meaning of Thysanura is Thysan means the fringe and Ura means the tail. Then second order of the Apterygota is the Diplura. So example is Diplurans, and the meaning of Diplura is the di means the two and Ura means the tail. Then number three, the Protura. So example is Telson tails, and the pro means the first and Ura means the tail. Then number four, Colembola. So the examples are springtails and snowflias, and the meaning is col means the glue, or embol means the pig. So these are the four different orders belong to Apterygota. So these are the different examples of Apterygota insect: bristle tails, silverfish, fibrant, snowflias, diplurans, tensile tail, Telson tails, and the spring tails. Then the subclass Pterygota has two divisions. First one is the Exopterygota, and second one is the Endopterygota. Then different characteristics. So first one is the wing development. So in Exopterygota the wing development is externally, and in Endopterygota the wings develop internally. And the metamorphosis, so in Exopterygota incomplete metamorphosis is present, or also called as the hemimetabola or the gradual metamorphosis. And in Endopterygota the complete metamorphosis or holometabola present, and then pupal stage is absent in Exopterygota, and the pupal stage are present in the Endopterygota. Then immature stages, so immature stages in Exopterygota are the egg, nade, or also called as the nymph and adult, and in Endopterygota the immature stages are the life cycle completed in the four different life stages, that is egg, larva, pupa and adult. Then number of orders present in Exopterygota is 16 in number, and the in Endopterygota the number of orders are 9. So this is the different characteristics of Exopterygota and Endopterygota. Then the Exopterygota insects having the simple metamorphosis. So these are the different orders of the Exopterygota. Then next is these are the different orders of the Endopterygota: Neuroptera, Coleoptera, Strepsiptera, Macoptera, Siphonoptera, then Diptera, Lepidoptera, Trichoptera and Hymenoptera. So these are the all about classification of insect. Thank you.